They were really welcoming when I moved here in 2001.
Started up in Woburn.
That was your first one.
Well, not my first one.
No, the first one was the Kool-Aid, right?
Well, I don't call it Kool-Aid. I call it fruit juice drink.
Fruit juice, yeah, yeah. That was your first one, right?
That was in Woburn.
Oh, okay.
It's where it grew anyway. It was in Medford for a while, but...
Yeah.
It was on Henshaw Street in Woburn, down behind the... where the registry used to be and where the gelatin plant used to be.
Okay.
Where Friendly's used to be at the corner of Montvale Avenue.
Okay, so right there, not too far. So, yeah, so why do you chose Woburn to start up?
It's a great city.
Yeah.
We started when I started this company, Cummings Properties, we started it right here in the city.
Yeah.
Started again down on Henshaw Street.
Okay.
They ended up buying the land there and some next door and put another building up and bought some more land across the street behind me here on Washington Street where Cummings Park is now.
That's awesome. And you never thought about taking any, I mean, I know you have properties elsewhere.
I didn't live in Woburn, I lived in Winchester.
Yeah, and I'm talking about taking the business elsewhere and kind of just, I know you have a couple properties in other towns.
We're in 11 towns all around.
11 towns all around.
And 42 years or so.
42 years.
But the first 20 years plus were 100% in Woburn.
Yeah.
It's a good city.
Yeah, in terms of the community and everything.
Sure.
I know you do a lot for the community. You give back a lot.
Woburn is a very diverse community.
Yep.
Woburn has got houses that people can afford. It's got apartments that people can afford as well. It's got great transportation. If somebody wants to live in Woburn and work in the big city.
Yeah.
But I don't know why anybody would want to work in the big city if they could work out here on 128.
Yeah, easy access to everywhere.
Sure.
So that's awesome. And now you're living in Winchester.
I've lived in Winchester for 50 years.
Yeah. You were from the Medford, some of your area?
Yeah.
Yes, okay. It is.
You do close-ups with that camera?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Starting small and making it big.
All right.
So, all right, let's forget about it. So what made you decide to write a book now?
It's life to think about it a little bit and try to figure out what your life is all about and what you've accomplished and see if there are some lessons that they can write down and put into a book that'll be helpful to other people.
Okay, yeah.
And that's really what it came down to.
Yeah.
What my book is really it's a book on business, it's a book on entrepreneurship, and it's disguised, however, as an autobiography.
Okay, that's great.
My life story is in there, but it's all about business. It's all about starting a business, about saving money and not spending all your money.
Yeah.
Being careful with how you spend it. Don't be afraid to spend it when the right thing comes along. If there's an opportunity, what's the biggest thing about an opportunity?
You just gotta take it, right?
Recognizing it when it comes along.
Yeah,
right?
And who said that?
Some guy from some Woburn here.
Yeah, that's fun. And another great thing that Gone went to.
100% of everything that we do goes to charity these days.
Another thing, your properties, all the rentals, right?
Yep.
And everything.
You started to ask about kids taking over.
Yes.
And then we cut each other off, maybe. My kids had other things they wanted to do.
Yeah.
And parents might always like their kids to follow in their footsteps.
Yeah.
I'd love it if it had happened that way. It didn't. I'm proud of what they are doing and what they will do. But, you know, it's got nothing to do with...
Yeah.
With the business.
With the business.
So there's 370 or so people. You mentioned Emily Holland.
Yes.
Her dad is the most senior of all our people. Did you know that?
That's what I heard. Yeah. He was one of the first ones here with you.
Yeah. He's the longest. He put up with me longer than anybody else.
But it's funny though, because I also know, not just from him, from other people, that most of your employees, they stay for 10 plus years.
We keep people a long time.
Yes. So one of my good friends that I went to high school with, he works for you in the electrical side. Which is Dave Kenton's name. He's the one that's like, I think it'd be awesome if you said, I didn't even think, I was like, no way he would sit down with me, but he's the one that kind of pushed me, so thank you, Dave. So another...
You tell him that Bill Cummings thinks he should sit down with you.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep. And another thing that you do that's awesome, I know you, to all your employees, if they have a non-profit, right? Yep. Organization, you donate some money to it, right? They pick.
Well, I'll let you be the first to break the news.
Okay.
That's true. Every employee at Thanksgiving time gets to designate a not-for-profit. The company will pay that organization $1,000.
Oh, see, that's awesome.
Okay. And the average seniority among all our people is more than 10 years.
Yeah.
So starting this year, everyone who has been here 10 years or longer, instead of giving $1,000, they'll get $2,000 to give. So they can give $1,000 to two different charities.
Okay. That's awesome. So
that's, just our, you know, way of recognizing that the people who make it possible for the company to provide a lot of money to the foundation to do its work, people who give us, who make that possible, are the people who are working here.
Yeah.
So why shouldn't they have, you know, part of the ability and the fun of it, really, to be giving money away? And that's more than most people are going to want to be able to, aren't going to be able to give that to the, you know, to the their kids' Cub Scout pack, or to, you know, the library, or
firefighters
or whatever they might want to do.
Yeah.
So this gives them an opportunity to help out their the things that are important to them in the community.
Yeah. Is that the 100K, what is it called?
What we call the 100 for 100 is $100,000 every year go to 100 different charities in Greater Boston.
Wow.
Greater Boston, and also in Essex County and Middlesex County.
Yeah.
So northeastern Massachusetts.
That's fine. And what about in terms of the city? Do you have anything business-wise in Boston itself, in the city, or just in surrounding areas?
We don't have anything in the city.
But you've been recognized a couple of times for, right, the Greater Boston, from being such a big influence in the real estate department.
Sure.
Right?
No, we give more money in Boston, per se, than any place else.
Yeah.
By a long shot.
And yet.
And probably on the least would be where I live, because there's not too many, the needs are less in Winchester.
Winchester, yeah.
But in, you know, in, get into Boston, you know, Lowell, Lawrence, Haverhill, Lynn, they are all cities that are important to us in supporting the activities there. We may not have any buildings there, but we hire lots of people who come from those cities.
That's awesome. Yeah.
So Louis, what we're trying to do, Louis, not Louis.
Louis. Yeah, yeah.
Which is it? Louis?
You're the one, yeah.
Okay.
You're the one works.
The thing that is important is trying to help put money back where it came from. The money, everything, you know, none of us have any pockets, or, you know, that you can't put anything in our pockets when we die. We can't take it anything along with us.
Yeah, that's true.
Our kids already have all that they need and all that they want. And they and their parents are trying to make arrangements so that money will keep on working and being able to do good things in the community.
That's awesome. We need more people like you around.
Well, there's people do what they can. You know, most people are going to do things for charity, helping out and counseling people and helping them and trying to educate them, as you're trying to do, and spread worthwhile information, huh?
Trying to, you know, if you only try. And another thing that I also saw that I thought it was really awesome, that you and your wife got recognized, were the first couple in Massachusetts to get recognized by giving the pledge. Is that the name?
Yeah.
How was that accomplished? Like, how do you...
It puts us in an interesting group of people.
Yeah, yeah.
There's some of the...
Who started?
It was started by Warren Buffett and Bill and Melinda Gates, so...
Buffett's the name.
We've found it to be a very worthwhile organization. We learn a lot about philanthropy there.
Yeah.
It's a room that we're, as you know, we're both pretty well off. But it's a place where we can go and be in the annual meeting with 150 other people, and 99% of them are much more wealthy than we are. So we're the very among the very poorest people in the group, if you look at it that way. And we just happen to be at a level where we can join the group, but most of them are a whole lot better off than we are.
Yeah, okay.
And it's not that we our friends are the friends that we've had for 40, 50 years.
That's what I mean.
And that's, you know, that's what we like. So
that's awesome. Yeah, no, I heard that from multiple people that you never let really the success of everything that you built so far kind of take over. You're still really grounded, and you treat all your employees and everyone around you the same. And that that goes a long way.
We all need to do that, right? That's why people like to be here, because they like the people that they, whom they work with.
That's so true.
They've got so many people who are here are just, they're friends of here.
Yeah.
And they keep, they work and they look forward to coming to work.
Yeah.
They know the company they're working for is doing good things in the community, and they're helping.
Yeah.
Helping us to do that.
Yeah. That's...
And obviously they still have to get paid and be paid fairly. And we hope that always happens. Most of them stay quite a while. Some of them will decide after they've been here, a month or two, or maybe a week or two, that it isn't right for them. They don't want to stay for whatever reason. That's fine.
Yeah, but
there's lots of places today to work.
Yeah, that is true. But I don't know. Most people seem to stay though. Now, what about just not so much in the business side as like family, even growing up with the kids? I know that growing a business takes so much of your time. How did you kind of manage that, like work with the family time?
I had a very busy wife.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
No, we managed to find time to do things.
Yeah.
And all relate to each other pretty well. Although I'll say I seem to have a lot more time for grandchildren than I did for kids now.
That's awesome. Yeah. How many grandchildren do you have?
We just got five, but that's...
Five. Just,
that's a good number.
Yeah, yeah. They must keep you busy.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you guys travel a lot. Try to, at least.
That's the one thing we do to spend money. We spend a lot of money traveling, probably.
What's your favorite place?
Oh, maybe Australia or New Zealand.
Yeah. That's awesome. Haven't been yet.
Yeah.
Put that on the bucket list.
I did something very special for when we had our 50th anniversary. I talked about not wasting money. We give a lot of money away, but we don't waste it.
Okay.
And I told my wife of the trip, our 50th anniversary trip, when we went to Venice, Italy, and we flew first class. It was the first time I ever bought a first class plane ticket.
Really?
Okay.
Yeah.
Why? Because you waste money. Is it worth it to, if we can get a ticket to, I think we went to Amsterdam first and then to Naples, and the flight over cost $350 or something. First class would have been
$1,550. Yeah.
And
big jump.
Sometimes it's stupid to spend money.
Yeah.
That doesn't have any value attached to it. Could we afford it? Of course we could afford it. We could have bought first class for everybody on the plane.
Full
and nobody wouldn't have made any difference.
Yeah. So
don't waste the money. And people. I talked to somebody who was a security watchdog person, one of our buildings, who happened to be from Somalia. And he used to travel home to Somalia, and he would get off the planes from the first class section. This is an important story I'm telling you.
Okay, make sure you get that.
He would get off the plane, and he always wanted to be at the first class section. He had a business. He founded a laboratory business that did very well. And then something happened in the laboratory business, and there was an accident or something, and he ended up losing it. And he still wanted to go back to Somalia. And he still had to fly first class because he couldn't have people see him getting off the rear door of the plane.
Yeah.
Because they knew he was,
And
he was working as a security staff, night watch staff.
Yeah.
And saving all of that money so he could fly first class.
Flight. That's crazy.
And things like that, trying to keep up and spend money to, to be, go to a concert, and you want to be down in the front row, and you're going to pay $500 for a ticket or something.
Yeah.
You can go home and you can watch it on TV and enjoy it just as much. I'm picking a bad subject. Maybe you're a big music fan.
No, but that's so true what you say. Just like you could easily afford that flight, but you just chose not to because you find your money to be better in other places.
Much rather give it away than to have it taken away from me like that.
See, I like how you put it. You give it away instead of throwing away.
Sure.
Yeah. So for the young people, what's your thing that you would tell them? Like to how to be successful, how to grow a business.
Work hard and save money.
Yeah, that's the mojo.
Well, really, that's where you're going to get it. I did it.
Yeah.
And there's so many. There's just as many jobs around now for young people starting out. You know, what did you know about real estate when you came here from Brazil?
Nothing.
All right. You're doing pretty well in it now. You're working hard.
Yeah, trying. Trying to stay busy, yeah. That's part of the game. Stay busy. Reach out, meet people.
We're going to bore your audience pretty quickly if we go on too much longer here.
No, I don't think so. But no, I appreciate your time. I know you have a lot going on with the book and everything, but
I'm honored and flattered that you wanted to come by.
I'm honored to be here. And I'm honored that you gave me time to sit down and share some great stories with us. I really appreciate it.
You do a nice job with it.
Oh, no, thank you. I didn't go to school for being a journalist, but we're trying. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time.